Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Keeneland Racecourse here on Saturday. It is the 17th of April, 2021. I'm going to look at the 9th race from Keeneland, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. The 9th race from Keeneland, it is the Elkhorn Stakes Grade 2 purse $200,000 race for 4-year-olds and upwards. We have a field of 10 horses heading to the starting gate. The distance of ground here of 2,400 meters, if you want to go by that, with the distance of ground of 1.5 miles on the Keeneland turf course, 2,400 meters, 1.5 miles here in the Elkhorn. Very good race. My top selection, we're going to go take the number 10 horse here at Red Knight. We'll go 10-1-6-2 in the superfecta. 10-1-6-2 super. Top selection of 10 horse, Red Knight. The 7-year-old gelding by Pure Prize, Bill Montrange, James Grand gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came 21st of November here in New York at Aqueduct. Mouth rates, inner turf course in Red Smith. And the horse finished second by a half length. He closed up from nowhere from a stupidly wide post rate. He sat back early, closed up well. North Dakota had the jump on him. But this horse ran a terrific race. There's nothing bad about that run back to Keeneland, where he likes to run on this turf course, 1.5 miles off the bench. I think he's sitting on a very good run. Two back in the Sycamore here in the fall at Keeneland, 1.5 miles on the 15th of October. He won by 2 lengths, and again, he sat back early. That's where he comes from. He likes to come from quite far behind. Sat back early, a little bit of a trouble trip in the stretch, but he got through, and he got the job done, winning by 2 lengths, 105. That was a very good run. And then prior to that, the Kentucky Turf Cup at Kentucky Downs, very soft going, 1.5 miles on the 12th of September. First off, a long refreshing. He finished second by 1.25 lengths, and he just couldn't catch Arklow, who's kind of drifting. Maybe just wasn't 100% cranked, but he still ran his heart out there behind a decent horse. And then prior to that, in the McKnight Handicap at Gulfstream, 1.5 miles on the 25th of January, he finished fourth by 3.75 lengths there. And he just really was a little bit wide and never really could keep up late. Maybe he was injured out of that run because you didn't see the horse for a few months after that. But he likes the long trip. Over the trip of ground, he's 5-2 with 2 wins, 2 seconds. He's only finished out of the money once. That came in the McKnight. So other than that, he's been pretty perfect over the trip. He likes Keeneland. He placed in this race 2 seasons ago. Last time it was actually running in April last year. If you remember, this race was running at the end of their July meeting here at Keeneland, the very special July meeting that we'll remember for a long time. But, he's coming back here, coming to this race well, training well. 3-1 will give him a shot. Your second likeliest winner is One Horse Cross Border. He ran a decent third, I thought, in the Pan American most recently at Gulfstream, and I thought his third before then, the Pegasus Turf Cup, wasn't bad at all. He likes the 1.5 miles. You know, he's a little lackadaisical times. It takes him a while to get going, but when he gets going, he runs a good race. 4-1, he can definitely win. We'll use him in the Moldies. And also, don't throw out the 6-horse tie to the Sea for Mike Maker. Again, won the McKnight 2-back very, very nicely on the front end. And then before then, the McDermott, and then after that, the McDermott, he ran a decent place. But, I don't know if they're going to let him walk the dog like they did in the McKnight a few starts back, but at 4-1, we'll give him a shot. So to recap my selection for the 9th from Keeneland, it is the Elkhorn. Let's use the 10-horse Red Knight top selection. Give kudos to the 1-horse Cross Border and the 6-horse Tide of the Sea. 10-1-6-2 in the Superfecta, 10-1-6 in the Multi-Race. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.